A second aspect that might be an advantage of the circular economy is environmental impact. Now, there has been a study regarding the environmental impacts of metals commissioned by the United Nations International Resource Panel. And in this broad study, three conclusions were drawn that are relevant for the circular economy. The first one is that metals are indeed very energy intensive materials, and that if we look at the global level, that metal production uses up 7 to 8% of the total global energy production. And this is really a huge amount. In the future, that is the second conclusion of that report, the metal demand is expected to rise and to go up steeply during the coming decades. Also, the third relevant conclusion is that the energy intensity of the metals is expected to increase as well. So that has consequences for the present, but especially for the future environmental impacts related to our use of metals. So let's go through these three conclusions in some more detail. Here we see a picture of the energy requirement of metals production in megajoule per kilogram of metal. We see that it differs per metal. Some metals are more energy intensive than others. For example, aluminium, that's the largest one, uses 200 megajoule per kilogram, while steel, that is only about 20 megajoule per kilogram of metal. So there are differences per metal, but if you would compare metals to other materials, you would still see that even steel is quite an energy intensive material. If you multiply that with the global production of these metals, you'll get the total global energy use for metals, and that is the 7 to 8% of the total global energy production that I talked about earlier. You see here that steel, although the energy intensity is lower, is still responsible for by far the largest part of the energy use, and that's just because it's produced in such huge amounts. Well, this amount of energy that we use now, 7 to 8% of the total global amount, will go up in the future. It will go up in an absolute sense, but also in a relative sense. And that's because of two things. One is that the metals demand is rapidly rising. And this is expected to continue over the next decades. And that's because the world is presently going through a huge surge of urbanization. In the next, say, 30 to 40 years, we will build the equivalent of all cities that we have now to accommodate the growing urban population. That means that we have to build up the infrastructure there. And for that, a lot of metals is needed for buildings, for roads, for bridges, for electricity systems. That all needs metals. So that means that we will need a lot more metals in the future. And therefore, the demand for metals will go up. And the demand for energy that we need to produce them also goes up. A second trend is the shift towards a renewable energy system. Solar energy, wind energy, even biofuels, bioenergy, all those renewable energies, they need more metals than the classic fossil fuel energy systems. And that means that if we move towards such an energy system, we will have to use more metals, so the demand for metals will go up further. The third conclusion has to do with the energy intensity of metal production. As I've said, metals are quite energy intensive materials, but this is expected to become worse in the future, and that has to do with the issue of the ore grades. It depends on the ore grade. The ore grade is the metal content in the ores in percentages. So an ore grade of 1 means that in the ore, there is 1% of metal. The lower the ore grade, we can see that in the picture here, the more energy is needed to produce the metal. And for copper, the ore grade has gone down from 2 at the beginning of the 20th century to 0.5 now. And that means that we really need lots more energy to produce copper now than we needed at the beginning of the 20th century. Ore grade for several metals have been going down for a variety of reasons. And that means that energy requirements have gone up. And this process is expected to continue in the future. Now, the secondary production of metals, which is the production of metals out of scrap and waste, uses less energy than primary production. So a lot of energy is needed to liberate the metals from their ores and to concentrate and refine them. And for waste metal products, well, they have already gone through that process. So this can reduce energy requirements per kilogram of metal, sometimes even by a factor 10. And this answers the question from the industrial ecology point of view, why we would need a circular economy. A circular economy for metals will use less energy. And it is, in fact, the only way to really reduce the energy requirements of metal production. Therefore, a circular economy will cause less emissions than a linear economy.